Welcome. The topic we'll be discussing in this lecture is linked lists. Okay. Previously, we have discussed about arrays. So we know what is an array. An array is a collection of data items of similar types, and arrays will occupy memory in consecutive locations. That is, if you declare an array, the memory will be allocated consecutively at some locations in the main memory, right? So successive items are located at a fixed distance or one after another, right? Okay, but this has a disadvantage also. The way in which the array contents are located, it also has a disadvantage. What's the disadvantage? The disadvantage is the movement of data during insertion and deletion is required. Say for example, there is an array with 10 elements, okay? So each element is occupying some location. Say first element is occupying the location 1000, so it's an integer array in the memory. So the second should occupy the location 1004, right? The third will occupy the location 1008, and the fourth will occupy the location 1012, so on and so forth. It will continue, right? And the fifth will occupy the location 1016, right? So it continues in this fashion. Now say these are the values available in this array: 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, like that. Okay. Now assume that we want to insert a value 7 in between 6 and 8. Then how will you do? Then actually, if there is another location, empty location, then you have to move the 10 here, and then 8 should come to the position where previously 10 was, and then in this empty location you have to add 7. Okay. So this is how you have to insert. Similarly, if you want to delete something, say I want to delete this 2, no more I want this, okay, then also you have to move the elements. Then 6 should be moved here, 7 should be moved here, 10 should be moved here, or 8 should be moved here, and 10 should be moved here. Like this you have to do. So this number of movement will increase as the size of the array increases. And actually it's very complex and tedious job, right? So, and also, so this is the main drawback with arrays, okay? So how to overcome this drawback? So this drawback can be overcome by using a particular data structure which is called as linked list, okay? So that's what we are going to discuss in this lecture and in some of the future lectures, right? Okay, fine. So in linked list, a pointer plays a crucial role, okay? So let us refresh little bit on the concept of pointers. See, here you can see there are two variables, int I and star pi. So I is an integer, I is a variable of type integer, and pi is a pointer to integer. Pi is a pointer to integer. And then float f and star pf, which means f is a variable of type float and pf is a pointer to float. And then we are saying that pi is equal to int star malloc size of int. So what is size of int? 4. Malloc means it will allocate 4 bytes. Will allocate 4 bytes of memory, and this memory location will be stored in the pointer. The starting address will be stored in the pointer pi, okay? So it is type casted, because malloc will return something of the type void star, okay? So we are type casting to integer star, which means that now this will be pointed by an integer pointer. So if the starting address of this location is 2000, then PI now will hold the value 2000. Okay, right? So I guess you remember this. So PI is 2000, star PI refers this value, right? Similarly for PF, what we are doing is float star malloc size of float. Size of float is also 4. So this will again allocate 4 bytes of memory. But here we can store a float value and it converts it to a and that address will be stored in the float pointer PF. Okay. Say this starting address is 3000, then PF will hold the value 3000. Then PF will hold the value 3000. So it means that it is pointing to this location. Okay. And now we are saying star PI is equal to 1024. PI is 2000. Star PI represents value at 2000. So that we are setting as 1024. Okay. And then we are saying star PF is equal to 3.14. PF is this. Star PI is this. So this will be set as 3.14. Okay. Then we are printing. Print of an integer. Integer is equal to percentage D. Float is equal to percentage F star PI star PF. So star PI in the sense, so this percentage D will be replaced with the value of star PI. This is 1024. So here an integer is equal to, you will get 1024. Okay. Similarly, this percentage F will be replaced with the star PF value. What is star PF? 3.14. So in this place, you will get float is equal to 3.14. Right. And then, so now once everything is done, we can deallocate the memory. Okay. So for that, we can use the function free. But you should remember that only dynamically allocated memory can be deallocated. Okay. That is, if the memory is allocated using malloc or calloc, then you can deallocate using free. Okay. So free of PI, this will deallocate the memory which is allocated for PI. Okay, no more this memory is available for us. Okay, so now this pointer becomes a dangling pointer. Similarly, free of PF, so this whatever PF is pointing, this memory is also, it will be deallocated. Okay, so this is a, so deallocate means returning the memory. So this memory is given back to the operating system, right? Okay, so this is a brief overview about or brushing up of the pointer concepts. Okay, fine. So there are several types of linked list, like single linked list, double linked list, circular linked list. So all those things we'll be discussing. But generally, what is a linked list? So a linked list is a collection of nodes. Okay, a linked list is a collection of nodes. It's a collection of nodes where each node contains two part. In a linked list, each node will have two part. One is a data part, the other one is a pointer part. Okay. So the data part will hold some value. And the pointer part will point to the next node. Okay. So a linked list is a set of nodes where each node has a data part and a pointer. The data part may hold some value and the pointer will point to the next node. Okay. So here you can see this is the linked list. This entire thing is a linked list. So this is called as the first node of the list. This is the second node. This is the third node and this is the fourth node. Okay. So you can see that the first node, it has a data part and the data part contains the value bat. And it has a pointer. This pointer is pointing to the next node. Okay, so next node, second node, its data part is cat and it has a pointer. And that pointer is pointing to the next node, okay, which is the third node. And the third node has a data part which is sat and it has a pointer which is pointing to the next node, which is fourth node. And the fourth node has a data part which holds the value vat. And it has a pointer part and this pointer is null, which means that it is not pointing anywhere, okay. So the last node will always point to null. Okay, in a linked list, the last node will always point to null. Okay, so now how a linked list differs from array? So you can see this particular linked list. In this linked list, there are four nodes. Okay, so this is node 1, this is node 2, this is node 3, and this is node 4. Okay, how a linked list differs from array in the sense, there will be some memory allocated for each nodes, right? Let us assume that there are 8 bytes required for each node. So n1, 8 bytes will be allocated. Okay, say 1000 to 1007 was allocated to n1. For n2 also another 8 bytes will be allocated, but that doesn't mean that for n2 you will allocate memory starting from 1008. No, it may be anywhere else. Okay, it may be anywhere else, right? But that is not the case in arrays. In arrays, the memory will be allocated at contiguous locations, but here it need not be contiguous. Okay, so for n2, maybe the memory may be allocated from location 1500 to 1507. It may be allocated here. Okay, only thing is n1's the pointer part will have the starting address of n2. So this is n2, this is n1. So in n1's pointer part there will be 1500, which means that it is pointing to this location. Okay, but it is not sequential, right? Similarly, n2's pointer part will hold the address of n3. If n3's address is 2000, starting address is 2000, okay, then it will have 2000. Okay, which means that n2 is pointing to here. Okay, similarly, n3's pointer part will have the starting address of n4. If n4 starting address is 5000, then 5000 will be stored here, which means that n3 is pointing to n4. Okay, and n4 anyway is not pointing anywhere, right? So this is how the basic idea of linked list works, right? Okay, fine. So because of this nature of linked list, because of its very specific nature of linked list, that is, each nodes are stored in different locations, and each nodes are not saved in the memory at contiguous locations. Because of these reason, insertion, deletion, all these operations becomes much easier in linked list when compared to arrays. Okay, in arrays, when you want to insert or delete, you have to perform lot of movements. So such movements can be avoided by using linked list. Okay, let us see an example, right? So assume that this is the original list. Okay, where the original list, assume this is the original list, original linked list. Okay, where the original linked list contains four nodes: bat, cat, sat, and vat. That is, the bat node's pointer part is pointing to the cat node. Cat node's pointer part is pointing to sat node. Sat node's pointer part is pointing to vat node. And vat node pointer is null, which means it is not pointing anywhere. Okay. Now assume that we want to insert a new node mat. We want to insert a new node mat in between cat and sat. We want to insert a new node mat which should be located in between cat and sat. For that, what you have to do is, first you have to move yourself to the cat node. First you have to move to the cat node. Okay, then what you should do in a sense, first move to the cat node. Okay, then what should be done in the sense, just make the mat node's next pointer to point where cat node's next is pointing. Okay, so this statement, assume that this mat node, let us call this mat node as a new node. Okay, let me call this mat node as a new node. Okay, new node. Okay, so this is the node we are giving to mat node. Then, and let us call this node as the previous node. Okay, that is the node which is before the new node. Okay, the node which is previous to the new node, let us call this as previous, this is new node. Okay, then how we will, how, what is the code you have to write means, first you have to make the mat nodes next to point to previous nodes next. Okay, so you have to write new node arrow. So normally this nodes are implemented by using structure concepts. Okay, and we will be accessing it using through pointers to structures. Okay, so generally we'll use arrow here. Later we'll discuss how it is implemented, right? So new node arrow next. So new node is nothing but mat node. So new node arrow next represents the next pointer of the mat node. Okay, the next pointer of the mat node, where it should point, it should point where cat nodes next is pointing. Cat's nodes next is pointing where? To sat. Okay, so which is nothing but, which is equal to, which is equal to previous nodes next. You getting? So what does it mean? So this expression will execute from right to left. Its assignment operator is there. It will execute from right to left. What is previous arrow next? This is previous. Previous arrow next is sat node. Okay. So sat node is now assigned to new node arrow next. What is new node? This is new node. Its next is this. So new node arrow next now pointing to sat node. That's it. It is as simple as that. Okay. So this connection we established. Then what should we do? Then we should make the cat nodes next to point to mat. Okay, cat nodes next should point to mat. So that, for that, what will you write? Cat node can be referred by using prev. So previous node arrow next. Okay, is equal to new node. That's it. Previous node arrow next is equal to new node. Okay, so again this will execute from right to left. What is new node? New node is this node. Is assigned to what? Previous arrow next. What is previous? This is previous. So its next is now pointing here. Okay, so no more this link is valid, right? But here what is important is this order is important. First you should make this connection. Okay, first you should make this connection, that is new node arrow next equal to previous arrow next. After that only you have to change previous arrow next equal to new node. Okay, this order is important, first this and then this. Okay, if you reverse it won't work. Are you getting? First if you give previous arrow next equal to new node, then what will happen? It means that you are making the previous next to point to new node. So this link is already broken. This link is already broken. Now how can you connect new node arrow next is equal to this? How will you refer? There is no reference. Are you getting? Okay, fine. So this is the whole logic. Okay, so here under the assumption that the previous node is referred as prev and new node is referred as new node. Okay, how we got this prev, that we will discuss later, but time being you understand this much. Okay, so this is how insertion happens in a linked list. Okay, now insertion becomes simple, right? So again to recall what here we are doing is we are creating a new node. So first you have to make new nodes next to point to previous next, and then previous next should point to new node. That's the logic. Okay, fine. Okay, next let us see how we can delete something from a linked list. Say I want to delete a node from the linked list. Say I want this node mat. I want to delete this. If I want to delete, how should I delete? Just make the previous nodes next to point to cat sat node. That's all. This is the node which we want to delete. What is its previous node? Cat. So cat's next now should point to sat. When you do that, it means it is automatically removed, because now bat is pointing to cat I mean, bat's next is pointing to cat, and cat's next is pointing to sat, and sat's next is pointing to vat, and vat's next is null, which means this is not a part of the list. Okay, so whichever the node you want to delete, that node's previous node's next pointer should point to the node which follows the node which is to be deleted. Okay, so how can we write logic for this? Let us assume that this node is the one which you want to delete. Okay, let us assume that this is referred using a pointer called del. Okay, this is our assumption. This node is referred using a pointer called del, and this node is referred using a pointer called prev. Previous, that is the node which just previous to the node which is to be deleted. It is not yet deleted, but instead of previous, we can call this as current node which you want to delete. Okay, there is nothing in name, it is just what we give. Okay, so the node which you want to delete, that is called as current, CUR. Okay, and the node which is before the current node, we call it as PREV. Okay, now how can we give this connection? That is, cat's next should point to sat. So how can you do that? So cat is nothing but PREV now. So PREV arrow next. Okay, PREV arrow next. Okay, that is the next pointer of the node which is previous to the current node. Okay, where it should point? It should point to the sat node. How will you refer the sat node using current node, which is nothing but current arrow next? It's nothing but current arrow next. Okay, what is current arrow next? Current arrow next is nothing but sat node. So current arrow next, because current arrow next is pointing to sat node. So this entire thing is nothing but sat. Okay, current arrow next is nothing but, it gives the address of the starting address of the sat node. Okay, and previous arrow next, this is previous arrow next. Now it is pointing to sat node. That's it. So it means this is reboot. Are you getting? Okay, so this is how deletion happens in a linked list. Okay, fine. Now, as I already said, linked list is implemented using structures. So how we implement linked list? Let us discuss that with an example. So to implement a linked list, we use statements like this. Okay, so here we are creating a structure, and the name of the structure is list node. And we are also using typedef, because we want to create a user defined data type for this structure. Okay, and this structure contains two members. One is data, which is a character array of size 4, and another one is a pointer. Okay, list underscore pointer link, right? So what is this list underscore pointer? So list underscore pointer, so actually it is not, it should not be list underscore pointer, it should be list underscore node. Okay, it should be list underscore node. Okay, it should be list underscore node star. Okay, it should be list underscore node star link. So basically it means that it is a pointer to the same node. It's a, because each node is of same type, right? Each node is of same type. Okay, the current node will point to the next node, and the next node will point to the, so say for example there is a node A, and A's pointer will point to the node B. So this pointer is going to point to another node which is of similar type, right? Which is of similar type. B is also another node, but it is similar to A, right? So this link part, so this instead of calling next here, we are calling link, okay? The link is nothing but list underscore node star, right? Link, okay? So it is same type, okay? The link is going to point to another node of the same type. So list underscore node star link, okay? So this is how we create an pointer. We use structures to create pointer, right? Okay. And then here, okay, this statement you should write here after this statement. Okay, here what we are doing, type def struct list list underscore node. Okay, type def struct list list underscore node star list underscore pointer. Okay, star list underscore pointer. What does it mean? It means that we are creating a user defined data type, and the name of the user defined data type is list underscore pointer. The name of the user defined data type is star list underscore pointer. That is, it is a pointer. It is a pointer to you. With this list underscore pointer, you can create a pointer. You can create a pointer that can point to a node. Okay, that can point to a node. So you can now directly create a pointer to the any of the nodes like this list underscore pointer PTR, and this PTR is assigned to null, right? Currently PTR. So PTR, actually PTR is a pointer. Here you are not using star symbol, but still it is a pointer. Because what is the type of PTR? List underscore pointer. And what is list underscore pointer? It is a name of a data type, but this data type itself is used to create a pointer. Okay, because it is star list underscore pointer, which is of type list underscore node. Okay, so this now PTR is a pointer. Currently it is not pointing anywhere, right? Fine. Okay, so there are two ways of creating this. See, here we have as in the data type itself, this is a user defined data type. In the data type itself, as you are giving list underscore pointer, so here when you say list underscore pointer PTR is a pointer, because this itself is a pointer, right? And you are making it null. Or otherwise, what you can do, you need not give here the star, comma is not there, you did not give here star. Okay, if you are not giving star here, then it means that this is a data type, this is a user defined data type of type, and it follows this particular style list underscore node. Okay, then here while declaring here, we should use pointer list underscore pointer star PTR, which means that PTR is a pointer to a node of type list underscore node. Are you getting? Because list underscore pointer is nothing but list underscore node. Okay, and then we assign pointer to null. Okay, but already here in the user defined data type itself, pointer is included. So when you create a variable, that pointer symbol you need not use. That's the point I'm trying to explain. Okay, fine. Now if you want to allocate memory for this pointer, once again you can use malloc. So PTR is equal to list underscore pointer. So this is for typecasting. Okay, list underscore pointer itself is a pointer. So star is implicit here. Malloc size of list underscore node. Okay, so this will allocate memory that is required for one particular node, which includes the data part. So list underscore node means what? It includes the data part, and also it includes the link part. Okay, right? And it allocates memory, and that memory will be stored in the PTR. So PTR will have a separate address, okay, and a node is created, and the node starting address, if this node starting address is 3000, then this 3000 will be stored in PTR. Okay, are you getting? So it means that PTR is now pointing to this node, right? So this is what this statement does. Okay, so this is how we create a simple linked list. Fine. Now, OK, Okay, now we already created a node, and that node is getting pointed by this PTR. If you want to assign some values to that, then how will you do that? Then it's very simple. Just you can say string copy PTR arrow data comma bat. Okay, it means what? In the particular new node, in the data part, now we are storing bat, string bat. String will normally end with backslash zero, so this zero. Okay. And if you want to make the, what you call, the pointer point to null, then you can just say PTR arrow link is equal to null. So it means that pointer part is will hold null. Okay. So this is the node. This is the node, and the node is getting pointed by the pointer PTR, because node's starting address is assigned to where? PTR. Okay. So PTR, if the node starting address is 3000, then PTR will hold 3000. Okay. And it is pointing here, right? It is pointing here. Okay. So the data part contains bat and the link part contains null. Fine. Okay. Fine. Let us stop here. So other things, let us continue in the next class. So basically what we have discussed in the sense, arrays, when you use an array, the content will be stored in contiguous memory locations, and because of that, inserting element into an array or deleting element from the array becomes complex, because when you want to insert anything to the array, then you have to move some of the elements, okay, so that a empty space can be created and there you can insert. Similarly, when you want to delete some element from the array, also you have to move some of the elements. So these number of elements to be moved will increase depending on the size of the array. Okay. To avoid such things, we are going for linked list. Okay. Linked list is a collection of nodes where each node has a data part and a pointer part. In a linked list, insertion, deletion, all these things can be done easily, right? So in linked list are generally implemented by using structure. We have discussed a basic example how a linked list is implemented, right? And also we have discussed basically how insertion and deletion are done in the linked list. Okay. Later we will discuss detailed program, like how we can create a node, create set of nodes, and how to insert and delete all these things. Fine. Let us stop here. Thank you.